All data in a DataView report is displayed through frames. These are rectangular boxes in which numerical and graphical data, explanatory text, and other visual components are displayed. Frames determine which data is included in the report and how this data is presented. There are a wide variety of frames. You can create, modify, and move frames within a reporter template. Frames can also be linked so that the data displayed in the parent frame determines which data appears in the linked child frame. In this video, we briefly introduce the types of frames available in DataView. We demonstrate how to create a frame, and we show how to link frames. To create a frame, click the DataView icon on your desktop. Close the Quick Start dialog box, and then select File from the menu bar. You can add a frame to either a template or a report. For demonstration purposes, we will add a frame to a template, so select Open Template from the File menu. This displays the Open dialog box. Locate and select the template file to be modified. Template files are identified by the extension DVT. In this example, we would choose the Pell Basic Report template. Note that if we later decide to save the changes we make to this template, we must save it under a different name. DataView does not allow you to modify and save a standard template under its original name. And be sure to name the new template with the DVT extension to ensure it is recognized as a template by DataView. When the template is opened and displayed on the screen, the icons in the toolbar are activated. These include a set of icons designed for creating specific types of frames. Draw a box creates a box frame. Draw a line creates a line frame. Draw arrow creates an arrow frame. Place word OLE creates a word OLE frame. Insert data creates an object linking and embedding frame. Insert text creates a text frame. Place table of contents creates a table of contents frame. Place graph creates a waveform or trend frame, depending on the selected data. Link frame creates a new frame linked to the currently selected frame. And finally, the generic new frame creates any frame type, including those for which no dedicated icon exists. Note that when you select a frame creation icon, the cursor changes to reflect the type of frame you are creating. You can also create a frame by clicking Frame in the menu bar and selecting New Frame. The cursor changes to the generic Create Frame cursor. In our example, we will place a simple text frame into the template. To do this, click the Insert Text icon and move the cursor to the location where the upper left corner of the frame will be placed. Click and hold the left mouse button, then drag the cursor to the location where the lower right corner of the frame is to be located. A dotted box shows the size and location of the frame being created. Then release the mouse button to display the Text Box Properties dialog box. Type in the text and use the buttons to select options for text font, size, and effects. When finished, click OK. The text frame now appears in the template, where you can make any final adjustments to its size and position. As we mentioned earlier, frames can be linked. This enables you to define one frame by the contents of another frame. For example, a meter frame can be linked to a channel graph frame. As you move the cursor in the channel graph frame, the data displayed in the meter frame is updated to display the values at the cursor position. In this example, the channel graph is referred to as the parent frame, while the meter frame is called the child frame. Note that a single parent frame can have multiple child frames. In addition, a child frame can have child frames linked to it. This creates a hierarchy of frames, with the top-level parent frame determining the data displayed throughout the hierarchy. Note that only graph-type frames support child frames. For other frame types, the link frame icon and option are grayed out. Consult the DataView help for a complete list of which frames can serve as parent frames and/or child frames. To link a frame to another, click the parent frame to select it. Then click the Link Frame icon, or choose Frame in the menu bar and select the Link Frame option. Either action displays the Child Frame Type dialog box. This lists all the frame types that can be linked to the selected frame. In our example, we will select Graph Legend and click OK. The cursor changes to the Link Frame cursor. Use it to define the size and location of the frame. Release the mouse button to display the dialog box appropriate for the child frame type, which in this case is Graph Legend Properties. Complete the selections and click OK. The child frame now appears at the selected location. This concludes our quick introduction to DataView report frames. Consult the help system that comes with DataView for detailed information about working with all types of frames. And be sure to check our YouTube channel for instructional videos and other topics in electronics, including the many products offered by AEMC.